The president's helicopter touched down on the grounds of the synagogue church. Waiting to receive him, Prophet T.B. Joshua, founder and owner of Synagogue Church of All Nations. This would be his first public appearance outside his church since the collapse of the hostel. Without wasting time, Prophet Joshua led the president straight off to the site of the collapsed building. And after taking a good look, the president turned to address journalists.
My personal condolences and that of the federal government to the church, to the prophet, the founder of the church, and especially to the bereaved families of the people that have died. And as you've read from the papers, a number of them are not Nigerians, from other countries, especially South Africa has the highest number. I spoke with the president of South Africa on Thursday to express my personal condolences at that of the federal government. And the issues of the cause of collapse is not what I can comment on since the investigation is going on, but we'll work with people to make sure that we don't experience such collapse again if it is something within the something that government can do. Of course, I spoke with the governor of Lagos yesterday. We are going to have a meeting with all the governors and the local government, the president of local government chairman, to see that we must assist, government must assist in terms of advisory issues to people who are building high-rising houses so that if it is technical issues, we'll be able to manage it better. But primarily, my coming here is to express condolences to Prophet Joshua, the Synagogue of All Nations, and of course, the bereaved families.
The president later left the site for a brief closed-door meeting with Prophet T.B. Joshua. After the meeting, the president made his way to the helicopter. Sensing this was a good time to get an interview, journalists swapped on the prophet.
All right, sir, in your statement you said the plane was targeted at you. Why will you say so? Sorry.
He scolded his personal guard for trying to shield him from the journalist, but he declined the interview.
I will give you opportunity. Don't worry. No, this is not the time. I will give you a statement, but not now.
All right.
Meanwhile, the South African High Commissioner to Nigeria, who was also around during the president's visit, later had a session with journalists where he gave a new figure of the number of South Africans who died in the incident.
You know that the search and rescue has ended, and therefore the number has grown up to 84, and that is what we have indicated. That is now 67 plus 17 is 84.
84 South Africans?
Yes.
So with this number now, it is assumed that all South Africans have been accounted for.
Well, we cannot say all South Africans have been accounted for until such time that our forensic experts have confirmed that. We are working together with Nigerians, not a question of being allowed. We have got diplomatic relations, and also we have time-tested relations that started during our struggle against apartheid and colonialism. So now we are working together with our Nigerian counterparts to make sure that we identify those people so that then they can be repatriated to South Africa.
South Africa is the worst hit by the collapse. Over 300 of its citizens were reported to be on a tour of the synagogue church at the time of the incident. Most of them were lodging at the hostel when it came down.